Welcome back to Sal's Garage. Today we're going to be installing some coilovers from BC Racing. Here are the new coilovers, and I'll be replacing my current setup, which is Megan Racing coilovers, but they are not custom made for my car, which is an E93 convertible. Since it's heavier, you need stiffer springs. So I went with the Swift spring upgrade, 18K rears and 12K front. So this should be significantly stiffer, so we don't have to worry about rubbing anymore. So here's my current coilover setup, Megan Racing. This is about 1 year later. I've had these for a while. They ride okay, they're just a little soft. So we end up rubbing right around there. As you can see, a lot of rubbing over there because these are a little too, they compress too much. So I'm hoping these stiff springs will allow us to go even lower without rubbing. I love the gold anodized finish here, as you can see. Really nice. So I've already got a DIY guide on how to do coilovers on an E93 M3. I'll leave a link at the top right corner of the screen so you guys can click that if you need an in-depth video, but otherwise we're gonna be skipping around here. Okay, so I just did the rears and the new suspension is pretty stiff. I copied and pasted in the settings, but it is still a way higher, so I gotta play around with the height settings to get them lower. This is the fronts now. I'm getting started on the fronts and I've got them out. This is the comparison of the Megan Racing versus the BC coilovers. This one has the Swift spring upgrade. You can tell it's skinnier, the springs versus this one. So I just finished installing the front and rear shocks and struts. And for the coilover setup, you can see, even when I copy and pasted the settings, the wheel gap is pretty big here. These springs are much stiffer, and as I'll demonstrate, I'm gonna try and balance the rear here. There's not as much travel, so that's a good sign. Let's go ahead and balance the front of the car and see how much this travels. This one?
It's not moving at all. Barely.
Oh, that one's really, this front one's really stiff. So the front one's definitely not moving. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna go ahead and turn the car on, drive it back and forth 3 to 4 times, let the springs settle a little bit, and then I'm gonna go ahead and then reassess and then start lowering and adjusting the height as necessary. So I have finished the project and I have lowered the car to our ideal ride height. Here is how low the fronts are. Can't even fit my finger anymore. That's pretty dang low and tucked. This is on the maxed out setting for ride height on the front. On the rear, it's close to max, but I can still fit my finger underneath, barely. Here's the rear and the front. Okay, so it is the next day and we are driving with the new BC Racing coilovers with the upgraded Swift springs. And immediately the difference I could tell is that the ride is stiffer, but that's a good thing because we don't want to rub as much. I was able to go a little lower than before, and in turn going lower, still not rub, at least not as much, unless it's like a really big bump. But I'd rather, you know, have the better look than to occasionally rub. Since the ride is stiffer, the handling feels better, less body roll, and comfort is pretty similar in terms of the shocks and struts and how they dampen the ride quality. It's because they have this, you know, they're the same shocks and struts as the Megan Racing. The only difference is the upgraded springs and the custom valving that comes with that. So I have it set to about 12 clicks from soft for the front and about 15 clicks for in the rear.
12 and 15. So far, very happy with the ride quality. And obviously, they're not KWV3's quality or Olin's Road and Track, but they're also not that expensive either. And I gotta say, these coilovers surprised me a bit. I didn't expect them to ride as that well. Usually, when the ride is stiffer, you feel more discomfort, but this is not bad at all. I can definitely daily drive this setup, and obviously there's a lot of adjustments. You can add more softness if you want to the ride. I'm pretty much in the halfway point for the dampening. Overall, I'd say I'm very happy with the springs. They ride well, they handle well, and they look well. They look really good. So I'll leave you guys with a pull here. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video. Have a good morning.